Umpire Donnie Schatz making sure we were all set. We appreciate that. Calvin Kastein at the West Plattsburgh American Legion Field. Lester M. Rock. I better not say Ernie Rock Memorial. Ernie might get mad at me. Lester M. Rock Memorial Field at post 1619. It'll be Schatz and Kringle, looks like, doing the officiating. It'll be the number two team in the league, the World Warehouse, coming in with a record of 11-1 with 10 wins in a row, going against the defending league champions at 10-2, a game behind the World Warehouse team, a Coors Light club. Offensively, these teams are close. The Coors team has scored 152 runs. They are seventh in the league in that category. World Warehouse has scored 166 runs in their first 12 games, allowing just 64. The Coors Light team has been a little bit better defensively. They allowed just 54. They are the number one and number two teams defensively in the league. Coors Light with 54 runs allowed in 12 games, and World Warehouse with 64 allowed in 12 games. So we're expecting a real battle. Could be an offensive battle, could be a defensive battle, or it could be a battle like a game that wasn't witnessed on hometown cable but took place at this field about 2 weeks ago. A big showdown between Northern Corridor and Big Earls, who at that time were tied for first, and Big Earls put a 19-4 thumping on Northern Corridor. So we're hoping that that won't be the case here. It'll be a little bit closer ball game, and time will tell as we get set for the first pitch here on Hometown Cable. Jared Jarvis will lead it off for World Warehouse. Kevin Levine checks his defense, and the first pitch is delivered. Jarvis hits it back to Levine. Levine will go with a Poirier for one down. These two teams met in the league championship series last year, with Coors Light, I believe, sweeping the series. So it's a rematch of that. Here's Jamie Moore, a shortstop, hits it back to Levine. It's going to keep him busy. And we have two down. I'll bring up the extra hitter, John Denny. It's hit through the right side. That's a base hit. Denny will coast into first and get himself a courtesy runner, probably. Or maybe not. We'll see. He will indeed. Moore will run for him. Now the cleanup man, second baseman John Southwick. Pitch from Levine is swung on. Chopped back to Levine. Levine shows Southwick the ball and tosses it to first for the out. So only the veteran Denny can get the ball out of the infield, and after one half inning, a World nothing, and Coors coming to bat here on Hometown Cable. Randy Ebersole is on the pitching rubber for the World. Caleb Kastein is his battery mate. First base, it's Christopher Kastein. Second base, John Southwick. Shortstop is Jamie Moore. And at third base, Gus Terry. In the outfield, there's Justin Sample. Who else is out there? Jared Jarvis, Craig Kastein, and Mickey Kastein. I think it's Mickey. No, it's Mike. Mike Kastein. Jay Drillette leads it off with a base hit. And he never likes to settle for a single. He's got great wheels, and he hustles that extra base every opportunity. Well, Gillette puts himself in the scoring position, and it brings up Scott Lemaire. Lemaire hits it up the middle. That's a base hit. Gillette will score. Throw is going to come to the plate. And Jared Jarvis firing to the plate, allowing Lemaire to go to second base. Randy Ebersole saying, come on, when that ball was thrown. He knows that ball should have gone to second. No way you're going to catch Drillette. Keep the man at first and keep the force on. Here's Jocko DeMars Jr. Strike one. Illegal pitch, 16 feet from the ground is allowed. It's a base hit, nothing but hits, and he Coors Light bats. And DeMars with an RBI. Now Neil Stevens, the batter, likes to chop that ball over the fence. Nobody out, cleanup hitter at the plate for Coors in the first. Straight away center, looks like it's got the distance. It does. Stevens going to chase DeMars around the bases here. And it's a 4-0 lead for Coors Light. Now Tommy Perry takes a strike. Still looking for the first out. This could be it. Terry drifting over near the fence. Almost underran it. One down. Hawk Purrier. It's a 2 left center. Two down. Here's Jocko DeMars Sr. Battling mosquitoes tonight. A lot of them out here. Terry looks at the trademark, fires to first in time. Couldn't quite get a handle on it, but he managed to fire it to Chris Gastein for the out. So it's going to be, 4 runs across for Coors Light. They lead after one full here on viewer-supported hometown cable. Caleb Gastein will lead off the second. Hits it hard on the ground and through the right side. And he will be on at first. A leadoff single. I'll bring up the third baseman, Gus Terry. Top of the second, 4-0, Coors Light leading. World Warehouse 11-1 on a season. Coors Light right behind him at 10-2. Hit. Deflects off the glove and hits the base of the fence here. Terry will reach. So Gastein is eliminated, and I bring up Chris Gastein, the first baseman. On the left field line. That's a base hit. In the gap. No, Drillette cuts it off. And it's going to be a one out single. First and second. Lefty hitting Justin Sample at the plate. Strike. High fly ball. That's two down. Runners will both advance. Now the pitcher, Randy Ebersole, at the plate with two men in scoring position and two outs. Big at bat for the pitcher. He comes through with a base hit. This should score two. Stevens will pick it up in the left field. Throws it to second, but Ebersole's in there. A big two-ribby double for Randy Ebersole. and it's a 4-2 ball game. That'll bring up Craig Castine with Mike Castine on deck. Stevens calls for it. 4-2, we're going to the bottom of the second here on Hometown Cable. There's Chris Brunel. Takes a strike to start the bottom of the second. Ebersole delivers. Coors leading it 4-2. To right field, it is going to be caught by Mike Castine. One down. Now Kevin Levine. Out of play. Gordy Devins and Gary Levine are the first and third base coaches. There's a base hit for Kevin Levine. Booted in right field, but he'll only get a single out of it. Brunel run for Levine and bring up Scott McCormick. Here's the pitch. Straight away center is going to be caught by Jarvis. Jared Jarvis can cover some ground out there. He just made an outstanding catch. Two down. Now Jason Drillet. Line drive up the middle. Brunel running for third. And a throw to third. That's not a. And Gillette ends up at second. No one to hold him and one to fold him. No one to throw. Here's Scott Lemaire. That's a base hit. It's going to score two. That's the difference between. Whoa. Gillette being at first or being at second, able to score easily on that. There's Jocko DeMars Jr. That's a base hit. McCormick will score. And they wisely hold the ball.
Come on, back.
Anytime you get on to bring up Neil Stevens, you've done your job. Anything else is gravy. Pitch to Stevens. In the corner. Foul ball. That's in the gap in the right center. DeMars will score. Stevens heading for third. He'll be in there with stand-up triple. So he's halfway to hitting for the circuit. Now here's Tommy Perry.
Got to have everybody in the dugout,
please. Two, pitch to Perry. 1-2 delivery. That is out of here. No doubt about that one. Tommy Perry. If there was an upper deck, it would have been in the upper deck. Two-run dinger. And Coors Light brought their bats tonight. Nothing light about today's team. This is a heavy hitter. Heavy hitters. Now David Perrier. Southwick makes the catch. Nice play. We'll add him up. We'll add him up and go to the third inning. According to my ciphering, it's 10-2 in favor of Coors Light. Mike Castine at the plate, leadoff. In the corner, foul. Foul bounces over the head of shortstop Perry. And Castine's on with a base hit. Top of the order now, Jared Jarvis, the left center fielder. He keeps it going with a base hit. 10-2 the score. There's Jamie Moore. Lemaire tripped on something. One down. And still made the force at second, so he got the out. No error there. And runners at the corners.
Stay in the game. Stay right in the game, buddy.
And John Denny, the batter. That's a base hit. It's going to chase home run number three. Moore rounding second, heading into third. Throw comes to the plate. Somebody not throwing to the right base out there.
What's coming, John?
So allows Denny to get to second base, so he can't get a courtesy runner. John Southwick, the batter. Second and third. 10-3 the score. It is over the fence, just barely over the fence. Just enough on it to clear the fence. It's a 3-run blast for John Southwick. That makes it 10-6 and puts the world right back in the thick of things. I'll bring up Caleb Castine, one out. Castine hits it hard and through the right side, a base hit. Jarvis running for Castine. Here's Gus Terry. Too much arc. Third inning. It's a base hit for Terry. Jarvis will stop at second.
They stick it on the ground here. Let's go, Buck.
There's first baseman Chris Castine. Strike one. Two. No, that first one was not called a strike. It's 1-1. Strike two. Payoff pitch. Swung on, chopped back to Levine. Gonna look for two, throw to first in time. A good 1-6-3 double play. We're gonna add him up and go to the bottom of the third. Coors leading World Warehouse. Jocko Damaris hits the first pitch to Moore. He fires to first, not in time, maybe an infield hit to lead off the bottom half of the third. Coors Light leading 10-6. And now Chris Brunell, the batter. That's a base hit. They'll be first and second. Now Kevin Levine, the batter. Eversole delivers. Through the right side. DeMars had held up. DeMars held up, and Brunell wasn't aware of it. Fast time putting the tag on DeMars. Now here we have long out. Brunell will score. It'll be out number two. That was Scott McCormick. Makes it 11-6. Jason Drolette at the plate. And Mike Castine goes back, makes the catch. And we're going to go to the fourth inning. 11-6 the score. Justin Sample at the plate. The team down 11-6, leading off the fourth inning. Hits it on the ground to Poirier. He goes to first, one down. Now Randy Ebersole. Ball one. Line shot to Stevens. Two down. Now bring up Craig Castine. He chops it back to Levine, who's had a very busy day, over to Puryear for the out. Three up, three down inning. We're going to the fifth, bottom of the fourth, halfway through this one. First ball hitting, Scott Lemaire. Fine viewer supporter, flies out to start the bottom of the fourth. We're checking over some stats. Didn't get the camera on time for that first pitch. Often happens on hometown cable, so if you're leading off an inning, always take the first pitch. If you're leading off the inning, here's DeMars. Off the fence. And Jaco DeMars Jr. is in at second. There's Neil Stevens. That's gone. Neil Stevens, you should have to swing with just one hand or some bat opposite handed or something. It's just not fair. Two run homer. Well, there goes his chance for hitting the circuit here. Instead of a home run, triple, double, and single, he's got two homers and a triple. Tommy Perry. He hit one at a time last time up. Two illegal pitches in a row from Ebersole. Two balls and a strike. Perry hits it high and fairly deep, considering how high he hit it. Sample grabs, two outs. There's David Puryear, Hawk, to his friends. This is an in-betweener. Moore goes back and makes the play. Two runs for Coors. They lead it 13-6. We're going to the fifth. Last time Mike Castine led off the inning, the World Warehouse team scored four runs. It's the first pitch to Neil Stevens. We have one down to start the fifth. I'll bring up Jared Jarvis, top of the order up for the World. Through the right side. Didn't get a glove on it, Perry, but Looks like a matador on that one. So that'll get Jamie Moore to the plate. Moore drives it through the right side. And it'll be runners at the corners. Now John Denny, the batter. It's on the ground. Safe at first. 13-7 the score. Southwick up. John Southwick, he homered last time up. Strike one. They'll get a base hit to center field. DeMars comes up firing. And two runs are going to score. I think it's 13-9, and Caleb Castine stepping up. Looking for his third hit. Fouls it off. Another hit for Castine. Southwick will try to go for third. He will be in there. That allows Castine to go to second. Gus Terry with two ducks on the pond. Called a strike. Hit to third. McCormick comes up firing. Safe at first. If I'm ciphering right, potential tying runs at the plate. Chris Castine, the batter. Bases loaded, one out in the fifth. Comes through with a base hit. Safe at first. Good call. There's Justin Sample, bag still full. I believe it's 13-10. Sample off the glove of Currier. A hard hit ball, that's a base hit. Two runs will score. Randy Ebersole. That's a sacrifice. Craig Castine, 11th bat of the inning. Seven runs in, I believe it's a 13-all game. Well, Mike Castine will lead off the next inning, and every time he does that, world scores. So I think it's 13-13, we're going to the bottom of the fifth.
Come on, Jocko. Little rope somewhere.
Jocko DeMars Sr. at the plate. Tie ball game, 13-all. Bottom of the fifth, and Coors has scored every inning thus far. It's a base hit through the left side. We got a pinch runner, don't have his name. Chris Brunell, the batter. He comes through with a base hit. Potential go-ahead run is at second. Now Kevin Levine. Locke Levine on four pitches. Bases loaded, nobody out. Scott McCormick, the batter. Bottom half of the fifth. One ball, one strike. Knocked down by Southwick, goes to second. Well, an RBI for McCormick puts the Coors team back up. Drillette at the plate. Ebersole, the first. No, I'd never see it happen. But I'd never see it happen. Drillette hit into a double play. ...14-13 after five. Coors Light leading World Warehouse. I believe it's 14-13. Mike Castine leading off another inning, and in the pass, the team has scored. One down. Top of the six. That looks playable. Drillette is back. He makes, oh, can't make the play. Jarvis is fast. He goes all the way into third. Jamie Moore.
Get it in. Throw it.
It's caught. Two down. Nice throw. Jarvis scores. Tie game. Well, here's John Denny. We're going to the bottom of the six. Tie ball game. Coors Light scored 4 in the first, 6 in the second, 1 in the third, 2 in the fourth, 1 in the fifth. They've scored in every inning. They're tied again. 14-14 in the bottom half of the six. Lemaire. Good. 3-0. You got Neil Stevens batting this inning. You don't want to put any base runners on.
Come on. Come on,
so they're going to get on. You want them to get, earn it. Hit to second. Moore comes up firing toward the first. Will not be in time. Good try. Drillette running for Lemaire. Here's Jocko DeMeyers Jr. Foul ball. The time is 10-10. The score is 14-14. 2-1 pitch. The line shot to Jarvis. One down. In three trips, Neil Stevens has homered, tripled, and homered. This time he almost took every soul's noggin off. It's going to be runners at the corners. Just one out, and Tommy Perry, the batter. This is high. It could be deep. It could be out of here. It is going to be caught. A long sacrifice. No. No, he's on. It landed. It was not. It wasn't caught. But everybody had to hold up, so it's a long single. I heard a thump, but it was off that... one of the signs out there, I guess. Here's David Hawk Purrier. It's now 15-14. First and second, one out. Up the middle, base hit. Andrew Goodrich running. There's Jocko DeMeyers Sr. Foul ball. That's a base hit. We'll score another run. Strike one to Chris Brunell.
No, John.
Two down. Mike Chastain making the catch. There's Kevin Levine. Line shot to left. Samples there. They stranded two. We'll add them up. I think they got about a three-run lead. We'll go to the seventh and tell you the score. Trailing by three, 17-14. The World Warehouse team will send up their four, five, and six hitters to start things in the seventh. Here's John Southwick. And he's going to get one of them runs back. His second home run of the game. Southwick will touch them all. We make it 17-15.
Hard hit, Merle. Hard hit, Merle.
What do you say, Caleb? Come on, Caleb.
Well, Caleb Castine's been up three times and reached three times. Takes a strike. Hit too short. First in time, one down. Now Gus Terry at the plate. Top of the seventh. World Warehouse 11-1 on the season, trailing the 10-2 Coors Light team, defending league champions. Under the glove of McCormick, Terry is on. That gets the potential tying run to the plate. It's Chris Castine. He comes through with a base hit. Potential tying run is on board, and Justin Sample, the batter. That one was a strike. Strike two. Or strike three. Strike three. Two down. That's a long walk back to the dugout when you strike out in slow pitch. But everybody who's ever played, if you've played enough games, you've done it. There's Randy Ebersole. Last hope now for the World Warehouse. Line shot to Stevens. That should end the ball game, and it does. A 17-15 hard-fought victory for the Coors Light team. They will move into a tie for a second with the World Warehouse Club. They're both 11-2 on the season, so that's the way it was in Adirondack Slow Pitch League, West Plattsburgh, Sons of the American Legion, American Legion Field. Full 16-19. Thanks for watching, and for those of you supporting, viewers supported local television, hometown cable. Win, lose, or draw, TV worthy your support. Hometown cable.